Okay, and then I can take next hose away. What is this hose? What comes from throttle body to this engine cylinder head area, and this hose moves air, and this is like oily hose, oily air. What goes, oily air goes in that room, that hose to the throttle body and then engine, and this is like emission control hose, and this hose number is now 6. It is hose number 6, and there is this my number plate 6, and I install this part in here, and now we have hose number 6, and then we go to take it out, and the slot connector area is in here, and let's go to loop that area. Okay, and now this hose connector, it is a little bit in here down area, and let's go to loop that area that we can see how to open that. Okay, and now this target area is in that one, and there is really one clamp, and when I move that clamp in here and then I rotate, now this part opens, and there's really one clamp in that way. And now this hose is free, and this is really hose number 6, and this hose moves air, and air goes through that hole and then to this throttle body, and this is like this camshaft air movement and in this direction, and hose number was 6. Okay, and then we have next hose left, and this is this hose, and now this is hose number 7, and I take my markings, and there is really hose number 7, and I install these markings in here, and this is like hose number 7. Now we can see that there's hose number 7. Okay, and now we need pliers like that, because there is this clamp, it is in that area, and it is difficult to open, and let's go to look that area closer. Okay, and now we can see this position, and position is in here, and maybe through these clamps I have difficulties to move that metallic clamp, but now I managed to do that. But I take also these pliers, and I a little bit compress, and now it's easier to move in that way, and now this clamp is there, and then I can a little bit rotate that, but this is again stack, and I need my bigger pliers. Okay, and there is again this hose is stuck, and that's I need bigger pliers, and I carefully rotate that in this way, and then I believe that this hose opens, or a little bit more work. Not yet. Okay, and now it opens. Good. Okay, and now when it is open, we can look that throttle body area, where it goes, and it goes in that down area in here. And now I have to open this clamp in here, and now if I install my tool in here, and then a little bit movement, now I manage to open this clamp, and then this is again stuck, and that's I need my pliers. Okay, and there we can see this my hose, and now I need again these bigger pliers that I a little bit move this hose in that way. and carefully in this way, and then let's look that can I take this away. Not yet, I need to rotate it more. Okay, and this cable is really stuck, and that's I need my pliers, and I install that in here in this way, and then I rotate, and now it opens nicely. Excellent. Okay, and now this my cable opens, and this is really this cable number seven, and this part moves again, or also this coolant liquid. This is liquid hose and pipe, and 7 was this hose number. Excellent. Okay, and now when I have removed all of these hoses and electric cables, now this throttle body is free, and I can take this throttle body in my hand, and there is really coolant inside, and there we can see this anode area, and also these sensors, and this hose, they are copper, and these parts are plastic, where goes this air, but these are like coolant hoses, these three. And there is then this gas pedal throttle body, and there we can see how throttle body moves. Excellent. And then we can go forward in this job. Okay, and then my next step is to open these electric cables what goes in this alternator and also in starter in here. And let's go to do those openings. Okay, and first I open these starter bolts and connectors, and there is cover what is in here, that one. And then when I open this cover, there is 10 millimeter bolt, and now I need 10 millimeter socket, and I open this bolt in here in that way. And now I can use my fingers, and there is really specific nut, and in that position I have to be carefully in this part. And there we can see this alternator nut, and now I take it away and look, there is another plate, and then I can take this alternator cable away. And it is good that I install these parts back, like in waiting, in that way. Good, and now this part is open, and then I open this connector in here. Okay, and then we have in here this one connector in that area, and for that opening I need pliers again. Okay, and I take my pliers, and there are my pliers, and I have to press in this area, and here there is connector. Now when I carefully press that and then pull out, now this connector opens, and there is this press area in this area in here, that part. Excellent. Okay, and then there is next cable, and this cable goes in the down area, and this is like air compressor, air condition cable, and its location is in here, and I take my pliers next. And there we can see this connector, and there are my pliers, and now I press this area in this little bit, this up area, this is my point, and first press and then pull out, and now cable is free in here, and this is this area what I need to press. Excellent. Okay, and now I have take out this alternator and also this air condition compressor cables. And then I have next cables in there. And let's go to look these cables, what is in here, and then in that one, in that area. And this cable is like knock sensor cable. And when I press this area in here, and then again, it is easy to open that one. And then there is next connector in here down area.